Joining me now is writer and broadcaster Esther Krakue. Esther, great to have you back. Now, we've spoken several times about the idea of Meghan Markle entering into politics, and with California Senator Dianne Feinstein passing away, talk has already started that Meghan is in the running. Is that a real possibility or just a flight of fancy?
Well, it's certainly a possibility in American politics. Stranger things have happened. And obviously, in America, you know, name recognition is a very powerful tool when it does come to politics. Look, a major Democratic donor has actually come out and said that Meghan's name has been in the running for a long time. Now, the decision on upon who... The decision for who the mantle will pass to following Dianne Feinstein's death is obviously going to be on Governor Gavin Newsom, and he's going to choose who's going to effectively finish out her the 13 months left of her term. It's been reported that Meghan and Harry had an hour-long conversation with Gavin Governor Newsom, but he decided to go with someone else. Ultimately, we know that Meghan has always been quite politically active, even before she entered the royal family, and I could probably prescribe all her political beliefs on the back of a stamp. But the reality is, it's not far-fetched to assume that she would eye, you know, a political career at some point in the future. Now, when in the future is actually the question here, because she still does have very young children and she might want to focus more on raising them as opposed to entering politics. But, you know, even Michelle Obama, who was the former First Lady of the US, she's always been thrown in the mix as a political hopeful. So someone like Meghan Markle, who holds very strong views, who's very, you know, adamant that she wants to see more women in positions of power, that's not something that I would... really be surprised if she actually chose to pursue that.
I think you're probably right there. And I think when you look at the American political landscape, it's almost like a soap opera in itself. So I think she'd probably fit in really well.
Yes, definitely. I mean, there's so many people that, you know, become famous in the US for whatever reason and then end up running for office because the name recognition is so powerful. You have, you know, from surgeons to business people to former actors and actresses, it really is a melting pot in terms of who can actually put their name in the running. And it's not something that would really surprise me given Meghan Markle's keenness to actually... you know, influence the conversation. I don't know if you remember a few years ago during the 2020 election, that video that she and Harry released encouraging people to vote for love, which was a thinly veiled request to not vote for Donald Trump. And they ended up succeeding on that front. But the reality is, you know, Meghan and Harry have always seen themselves as some sort of power couple, and their mission is to do good. And what better avenue to do good than to actually, you know, influence public policy? Now, whether she'll actually get very far in that quest is a completely different story. You know, the American public have been cooling towards the Sussexes for a while now. They've kind of gotten over the whole royal family saga. So it'll be interesting to see what she offers. I suspect it will be, you know, a very, very feminist-driven sort of political campaign. But, you know, we'll have to see, even if she does, to see whether she actually does even end up taking that step in the first place.
Now, a story that has been reported but won't quite go away alleges that Harry and Meghan have attempted to gag teachers and students as young as five from making future comments about a Sussex's visit to a school in 2021. I feel like it's very thin-skinned, and obviously if Meghan does go into politics, she won't have the luxury of gagging anyone in the public. Why would the Sussexes attempt something like this? I mean... The perception was only going to be poor, wasn't it?
I mean, this is one of those things that really highlights their need to kind of control the narrative around them. We obviously know that in the royal family, they felt like they didn't have the protection of the firm in terms of influencing the conversation about them, you know, leaking stories to the media, as they claimed, that were unfavourable to them. So their image has been something that they've really tried to curate as accurately as possible. I have heard rumours that actually the gag order was upon a recommendation of a member of their team. So it didn't actually come from them. But it wouldn't surprise me if that's something that they went on board with. You know, this visit that they did to the made to the school in Harlem in 2021, you know, you could have children saying all sorts of things that might not be particularly favorable. They might say she didn't smell very nice or she wasn't very polite or whatever. And obviously to have that swirling in the media, particularly at the time that they did conduct this visit, might not have been particularly opportune for them. So I'm not surprised that something like this will happen. But you're absolutely right. If Meghan were to enter the spotlight in a different way in the political arena, she wouldn't have the comfort or the backing of being able to gag everyone. You know, politics in the US is, or anywhere, but particularly in the US, is blood sport. People run campaigns based on a gaffe you made 20 years ago. And, you know, there's more than enough content for people that would want to put out negative press coverage about Meghan Markle. I mean, I'm pretty sure there are staff members in the royal family that won't have a lot of positive things to say about her. But I think what this really does highlight is the fact that the Sussexes are so adamant that they want to curate their own public image. And unfortunately, the more they seem to do that, the more they actually fail. Many people don't understand, but actually the royal family and their coverage of Prince Harry over the years, even from his Nazi costume to all the gaffes he's made, they really actually saved his public image, because ever since he's left and he's been completely in charge of his image alongside his wife Meghan Markle, it's completely tanked. And it just shows that sometimes actually having the protection of people you may not always agree with is a blessing more than a curse.